Good evening, students. So today we'll discuss about zoology topic. One half in that zoology, one half syllabus. So today you wrote exam on this same topic. So that same discussion we are going to do now. So we'll start with question number one. In question number one, changes that allows conversion of larva into an adult is called as, the direct definition they asked, conversion of larva into an adult is called metamorphosis. Conversion of larva into an adult is called metamorphosis. Changes that allows conversion of larva into an adult is called metamorphosis. What they asked in options? First option, metagenesis is observed in frog. So usually in frog you will not find metamorphosis. When frog is in larval stage, then only you will find metamorphosis. Once it completes larva, frog larva completes the metamorphosis, it will become complete adult frog. So before that, it will undergo a process called metamorphosis. So that metamorphosis is different and metagenesis is different. Metagenesis means what? Here I'll write. So metagenesis means alternation of generation. What alters here? Asexual generation. Asexual generation alters sexual one. So this phenomenon we called it as metagenesis. So this first option is wrong one. Second option, metamorphosis and is observed in mammals. In mammals you will not find any larval stage. So this is completely wrong statement. Second one. Third one, metamorphosis and observed in tadpole larva. So tadpole larval stage you will find in frog life cycle. So this is answer. And fourth option, what they have given, metagenesis and is observed in cnidarians. So metagenesis of course find in cnidarians. So this metagenesis is different and metamorphosis is different. So conversion of larva into an adult is called metamorphosis, not metagenesis. So now the correct answer will be third option. Next motto, second option. Which of the following statements are true or false? First statement, in a torpedo. So torpedo that belongs to this species belongs to cartilaginous fishes. Belongs to cartilaginous fishes. So these cartilaginous fishes, like a torpedo, the electric organs are capable of generating the strong electric shock to paralyze the prey. This is correct only. So they may have that capability to generate an electric current of about 40 volt. You just keep it in your mind, 40 volt. So this first statement is correct. And second statement, bony fishes or osteanthes use pectoral, pelvic, dorsal, anal and caudal fins in swimming and balancing. So this is correct statement. Next, move to statement number three. Amphibian skin is moist and has thick scales. So you have to keep it in your mind that amphibian skin is of course moist, but this skin will not have any scales. That's what we'll write it as alternative word as devoid of scales. Devoid in the sense what? Absence of scales. Always amphibian skin is moist, but it is not having any scales. This statement is third statement is wrong one. Fourth statement, birds are pyclothermic. So birds are, this is completely wrong statement. Birds are homeothermic. You have to remember that birds are homeothermic. Example, birds and mammals are homeothermic. Examples of pyclothermic are cold bladder means. So from fishes to up to what? Reptiles will comes under this pyclothermic animals. Then fifth statement, the most unique mammalian characteristic is the presence of milk producing mammary gland by which they nourishes the young one. This is also correct statement. So now how many statements are correct here? So first one, second one and fifth one are true, but third and fourth statements are false. So that's what option two will be the correct answer for question number two. Next, when we move to question number three, This is very easy question. Metagenesis. We have already discussed in first year chapter in Animal Kingdom, especially in while studying the characteristic feature of ciliated. When you take the ciliated characteristic feature, one of the main important characteristic feature is metagenesis. Metagenesis means what? Alternation of generation. I have already discussed in previous question. Alternation of generation. So asexual generation alters the sexual. Once again, sexual generation alters the asexual generation. So that's what they have given in first option as presence of different morphic forms. So this is what related to polymorphism. You have to keep it in your mind. Related to polymorphism, this statement is wrong. Second option, alternation of generation between asexual and sexual phase of an organism. So this second option is correct one. Then third one, occurrence of drastic changes during post-embryonic membrane. This is not completely related with this. Fourth option, presence of segmented body and parthenogenetic mode of reproduction. Parthenogenetic means what? So fertilization, without this fusion, without fertilization, young one will get produced. So this phenomenon completely in this not there. Option second is the correct answer for question number 3. You have to keep it in your mind. So then when we'll move towards question number 4. Solenocytes and nephridia are respectively found in. Solenocytes are the excretory organs. You have to remember that excretory organs in flatworms, and nephridia are the excretory organs in annelids. So that's what they're asking. Solenocytes and nephridia are respectively found in. You just keep it in your mind, respectively. So cnidaria, in cnidaria will not find excretory organ as solenocyte. In mollusca, nephridia not there. Annelida, solenocyte not there. Nematoda, nephridia not there. Platyhelminthes, solenocytes are the excretory organ. Annelida, nephridia are the excretory organ. So now third option is correct matching. So that's another name of the solenocyte means, you just remember that as flame cells. We'll also call it as flame cells. Or these flame cells are also calling it as protonephridia. All names are same for this solenocyte. Solenocytes are the excretory organ in Platyhelminthes, and nephridia are the excretory organs in Annelida. You have to remember this point. So, and along with that, in Annelida, nephridia are of different types. So, types of nephridia will find. So, first one is called pharyngeal nephridia. Second one is called septal nephridia. Third one is called integumentary nephridia. So different types of nephridia you will find in annelidans. All three will be involved in same function, that is excretion and osmoregulation, maintenance of water and salt balance, along with that excretory waste to be excreted out of the body. So with the help of all these different types of nephridia, so now the answer will be third option, Platyhelminthes and Annelida respectively. So when we move towards question number 5, so that's what they have given as assertion and reason. So first, what they asked in assertion, amphibian males and females produces lot of gametes. Is it correct or not? So 100% this is correct only. Amphibian male will produce millions of sperm, and along with that females will also produce at a time. So lot of gametes. So how, when male frog will sit on the female frog, so this female frog abdomen will have a pair of ovary. So in that matured ova will find, when squeezing of male frog the abdomen of the female frog, so together will undergo external fertilization in the aquatic medium. So this is what we called it as amphimixis. Is it or not? So this is correct only. Next, in reason, what they asked, males lack copulatory organ in amphibians. So this is Correct only. So males, frogs will not have a proper copulator organ. How this human male and other vertebrate will have this penis as a male copulator organ during insemination process released into the female genital tract, semen. So like that, not there in the amphibian. So how they will communicate with this ova means in the aquatic medium by creating vibrations. So male will release the sperms in the aquatic medium by squeezing of female abdomen. So females will also release the ova in the same aquatic medium. So with the help of this vibrations in the water, so external fertilization takes place. That's what proper copulatory organs are not there in the male frogs, especially in amphibians. So that's what assertion is also correct, reason is also correct. But what happens here, as reason is not correct explanation to assertion. So that's what second option is the correct answer for this question number 5. So next, when we move to question number 6, this is very easy. The portal system is seen in all vertebrates. In all vertebrates, which portal system we will find? Usually, three types of portal systems are there. One is called renal portal system, hepatic portal system, and the third one as hypophyseal portal system. So here, this is not related with this hypophyseal portal system. Now, you have to know about this two different types of portal system, renal portal system and hepatic portal system. Hepatic portal system is the answer here. In all vertebrates, you will find hepatic portal system. But renal portal system, you will find all the vertebrates except mammals. In mammals, not there. In hagfish. In hagfish, you will not find. Along with that, in lampreys. In lampreys also, you will not find renal portal system. So now, this answer will be hepatic portal system. Next, move to question number 7. Molting occurs commonly during the development in. Molting in the sense what? Ecdysis. Ecdysis in the sense shedding. In some animal, shedding of skin takes place. In some animal, shedding of cuticle takes place. In some animal, shedding of feathers takes place. In different animals, shedding process will be there. Especially in which phylum animals this type of molting will be there, they are asking. So option 1, Annelida arthropoda, Trematoda nematoda, Arthropoda iconoderms, and last option is Nematoda and Arthropoda. So option 4th is the correct answer. Why? Because in Arthropoda, ecdysis you will find, they will undergo, insects will undergo 13 times molting. They will undergo 13 times molting. When they will completely all 13 times, so 14th time they will become adult cockroach. One best example for insect means you can take cockroach. In cockroach, how many times it takes place? 13 times. 14th time only. So young cockroach will convert into adult one. So this process is called ecdysis or molting process. Like that only in nematodes also, especially in Aschehelminths also, at the end. At the end of cycle, so these will also undergo 4 times molting. But here 13 times molting is there. So that's what the 4th option is the correct answer for 7th question. Then move to question number 8. So what they gave here, which of the following not a character of cockroach? You have to remember here, cockroach. Their fertilized eggs are encased in capsules called utheca. This is correct only. So encased in the sense, within that they'll keep the fertilized eggs. That covering layer is called, covering egg-like structure is called utheca. Second option, on average, females produce 9 to 10 utheca, each containing 14 to 16 eggs. This is uncertain sentence, correct only. Third option, the nymph grows by molting 13 times. In previous question, I have already told you, cockroach will undergo 13 times molting. The previous underdeveloped stage is called nymph. So young cockroaches are also called nymph. Nymph will grow by molting how many times? 13 times to reach what? Adult form. This is correct only. Fourth option, the nymphal stage means young cockroaches have wing, but adult cockroaches have wing pads. Opposite they have given. Actually, nymph stage they have wing pad. Wings are not well developed. When they will attain after completion of 13 times molting, they will attain as adult cockroaches. Adult cockroaches will have wings, not wing pads. This is wrong statement. That's what answer will be fourth option. Next come to question number 9. Here one diagram is there. You have to show all these labels. So first one, a common character between the diagram in the next question. In this question what they gave, ninth question, a common chamber between septal nephridia of earthworm and the Malpighian tubule of cockroach is both have ciliated funnels discharge into the alimentary canal or segmental structures discharge directly outside the body. So what they ask here, so character, common character between septal nephridia. So septal nephridia are a type of nephridae will find in annelida, will have a function of excretion and osmoregulation. So here also they'll excrete out whatever excretory waste material is there directly into the alimentary canal, That's what such type of nephridia are also called enteronephric nephridia. So similarly, Malpighian tubules. So here in cockroaches also, Malpighian tubules are the excretory organs. So these excretory organs, first they will absorb from the hemolymph, blood. So absorbed uric acid, excretory waste in the sense what? Uric acids. So that uric acid will absorb and later, so this will also get released into the alimentary canal. Both excretory organs, they will first receive the excretory waste and both will get released into the alimentary canal. So that's what, so this second option will be the correct answer for this ninth question. Next, move to question number 10. So what they gave in that diagram given below the figure of open circulatory system of cockroach. Of course, arthropodans will have open type of circulation. Identify A, B, C and choose the correct options. What they gave here? So in diagram, you have to check once. A is the anterior aorta, B is the alary muscles and C is the chambers of heart. So option 3 will be the correct answer. Move to question number 11. In which of the following structures there is outer layer of thick circular muscles and inner cuticle with 6 chitinous states? So 6 chitinous states you will find in digestive system of insects, especially in cockroaches. When you take cockroach digestive system, in this alimentary canal, you will find a storage organ called a crop. So below this crop, you will find a 6 chitinous teethy structures within a structure called, these are looks like a 6 teethy structures. So this structure is called proventriculus. This structure is called proventriculus, or we'll also call it as gizzards. So this gizzard function means grinding action, grinding of food material. This is the main function of gizzard or proventriculus. Within that gizzard or proventriculus, you will find 6 chitinous states. So now this 11th question number, option 2 is the correct answer. Now move to question number 12. The earthworm gets a grip over the soil during locomotion. So this common question they asked so many times in the previous exams. So the earthworm gets a grip over the soil during locomotion means what they asked indirectly, what are the locomotory organs in earthworm? So earthworm belongs to which phylum? Annelida. What are the annelidans locomotory organs? Setae. So the exact answer will be setae. What they asked in remaining options, first option chloragogen cells, especially you will find in rhizogen cell. So these are similar to, these are similar to liver cells of vertebrate animals. How we have this liver cells or hepatocytes na? So that what the function of liver cell is there in human being and other vertebrate, the same function done in annelidan. So one best example, one best function of these liver cells in human body means conversion of glucose into glycogen. So that glycogen will get stored in liver. Like that only same function will done by these chlorogen cells in annelidan. So this is the main function. Spermatheca. Spermatheca means they will store the sperms after copulation. After copulation in hermaphrodite animals, what will happen? Mutual exchange of only sperms takes place. Once both earthworms will get mutual exchange the sperms, means that exchanged sperms in that particular earthworm will get stored temporarily in a region called spermatheca. Then comes the third option, what they give? Clitella. So clitella means this is a glandular tissue. This is commonly called glandular tissue. So this glandular tissue will have a one main important function called formation of cocoons. It forms a egg case in earthworms. Fertilized eggs are present within that capsule structure called cocoon. So this also helps in copulation process by secretion of mucus-like substance. So that thick mucus-like substance during copulation time, it helps in attaching the both earthworms in a position. So now this answer will be CT. Next question number 13. In question number 13, fecal deposits of earthworm are known as, fecal deposits are called worm castings. So these worm castings, they will use as a natural fertilizer. Farmers, they will use as a natural fertilizer. So this natural fertilizer can increase the fertility of the soil. Increases the fertility of soil. That's what we call as friends of farmers. That's what we called as friends of farmers. Manure in the sense cow or any other animal dung is called manure. Dung in the sense that only. Organic matter, so different types of organic matter will come. So now this fecal deposit of earthworm are known as worm castings. Now move to question number 14. In the composition of cellular mass, arrange the components, proteins, carbohydrates, lipids and nucleic acids in ascending. Ascending means from small to large, percentage wise. What is the percentage of lipids? 1 to 2%. Then carbohydrates, exactly 3%. Then nucleic acids, 5 to 7%. Then proteins, 10 to 15%. Maximum will be water, that is more than 70%. Right? Ions, 1%. You have to remember all, but they ask here only about components like proteins, carbohydrates, lipids and nucleic acids. So in ascending order means so from smaller to larger. Descending means from larger percentage to smaller percentage. Now the answer will be third option. Next move to question number 15. Which statement is correct for biomolecules? So biomolecules, they are asking the correct statement. So first option, DNA is a polymer of ribonucleotide. So this is a wrong statement. Why? Because DNA is a polymer of deoxyribonucleotide. You have to keep it in your mind. Deoxyribonucleotide, not ribonucleotide. That statement is wrong. Second option, all carbohydrates break down into glucose. No, some into galactose, some into fructose, some into glucose. Not all into glucose. This is wrong one. Third one, sequence of amino acid determine the primary structure of protein. This is exact NCERT sentence. Last one, RNA is single-stranded, correct only. And contain all purine bases are different from that of DNA. No. So always purines are adenine and guanine. This you will find same in both DNA and in RNA. But it will differ only in pyrimidines. Pyrimidines are C and T. Instead of in RNA, you will find C and U. T is replaced by uracil. You have to remember this, purines and pyrimidine. So purines are same in both, only different pyrimidines. AG, CT. AG, CU. Understood? Now the answer will be third option. Next, move to question number 16. Direct, they asked one structure. The given organic compound is a diagrammatic representation of adenosine. So when you'll read this, compulsorily you have to read NCERT. When you'll read NCERT, you'll get this structure, adenosine. Next, move to question number 17. What they asked in 17th question? The repeating units of polysaccharide are linked by which bonds? Always you have to remember that between glucose, you will find glycosidic bonds. Answer will be glycosidic. But what about phosphodiester bonds? Phosphodiester bonds are present between nucleotides. Nucleotides are the structural and functional units of nucleic acids. In nucleic acids, you will find phosphodiester bonds. These are present between nucleotides. Glycosidic bonds are present between the glucose molecules in polysaccharide. Like that only third one, peptide bond. Peptide bonds are always present between the amino acids. Amino acids means like that so many peptide bonds are present between so many amino acids and togetherly forms a protein molecule. You just keep it in your mind. Then fourth one, hydrogen bonds. Hydrogen bonds are present in protein structure also. Along with that, in formation of this water molecule also, you will find this structure of water molecule. Within that structure, you will find between hydrogen and oxygen, you will find hydrogen bonds. So now this answer will be glycosidic bonds are always present between the glucose molecules. So now come to question number 18. Malonate inhibits succinate dehydrogenase is an example of. So when the structure like a substrate, this is enzyme. Always enzyme will bind to substrate. It forms as enzyme substrate complex, then into enzyme product complex. This is a common enzyme action reaction. So what happens in competitive inhibition? When enzyme is binding to substrate like molecule, this is not exact substrate. So instead of substrate molecule, this will get a shape like substrate. And when enzyme will binds with that particular substrate, this will not allow this formation of enzyme substrate complex. So that type of inhibition process is called competitive inhibition. In competitive inhibition, the substrate will binds to an enzyme, active site of an enzyme. So that will be looks like a same. When it once fixes to that particular active site of an enzyme, this will not allow further substrate will be binding with that active site of an enzyme. So thereby, this will not allow the formation of enzyme substrate complex followed by enzyme product complex. That's why this complete enzyme action will get completely reduced due to competitive inhibition. That phenomenon is called. So such type of substances are called competitive inhibitors. Now the answer will be competitive inhibitor. They asked in question option number one, competes with malonate. It is not competing with malonate. It is competing with succinate, succinic dehydrogenase. So by say suppressing this one, it completely inhibits the enzyme action. So now this 18th answer will be second option. So now move to question number 19. Grinding of a living tissue in a trichloroacetic acid. So when you'll grind the living tissue in a trichloroacetic acid, show a presence of an inorganic compounds. Inorganic compounds are always comes under acid soluble fraction. Is it or not? So we have already discussed while studying this biomolecules chapter. So we'll divide into acid soluble and acid insoluble. So acid soluble means all inorganic will come, along with that polysaccharides will come. Is it or not? So all will come. Insoluble means which one is larger. So they will settle at the bottom. So which one will have more than 800 Dalton molecular weight, so they will settle at the bottom. So that's what we'll consider under insoluble fraction. But inorganic compounds will comes under acid soluble fraction. This is direct answer for this question. Next, in question number 20. So read the statements carefully and answer the question. What they gave in these statements, you have to read it carefully. So first statement, hydrolysis are nothing but breakdown. So hydrolysis of glycogen into glucose is termed as what you will term? They have given an option, glycogenolysis, gluconeogenesis, starch, and glycogen phosphorylase. First one answer will be glycogenolysis. Lysis means what? Breakdown. Glyco means what? Glycogen. So glycogen breakdown takes place, that yields as glucose. So this is correct for first one. And second statement, name the enzyme which takes part in hydrolysis of glycogen. Which enzyme will be involved in breakdown of glycogen? Glycogen phosphorylase. You have to remember. Then third statement, amylum. Amylum, another name of amylum is also called starch. Third one. Name the polysaccharide formed at the end product of photosynthesis. Almost all the plants, they'll undergo photosynthesis process. At the end of photosynthesis, they will produce glucose units. These glucose units combine to form a polysaccharide. So that polysaccharide, they will store in different parts of the plant body. So like you can take in stem part, like in tuberous plants, tuberous stems are there. In that tuberous stem, they'll store the polysaccharide in the form of starch. Is it or not? So this is answer. Correct option of all the answer is first option. Very easy. You have to read once. So next to move to question number 21. In question number 21, what they gave here? The single enzyme involved in the following reversible reaction. Reversible in the sense what? In both the direction. Which enzyme? Carbonic anhydrase. Of course. So while studying that breathing and actions of gases in that chapter, we have already discussed one reaction. When carbon dioxide binds with this water molecule, it is reversible one. It forms as H2CO3. So what H2CO3 means? Carbonic acids. So this is once again unstable compound, immediately dissociates into HCO3 minus plus of hydrogen ions will get dissociate from that. So this reaction we already discussed in the previous exam. So this is what correct carbonic anhydrase enzyme is correct in both the side. But for that carbonic anhydrase activation, which cofactor is needed? So here magnesium. Here, zinc they have given. So now the correct answer will be zinc will be the cofactor for this carbonic anhydrase. Now the answer will be second option. Without zinc in our body, so this carbonic anhydrase will not get activated. If it is not get activated, means what will happen? So carbon dioxide will not bind with this water molecule. It will not form as carbonic acid. It will not dissociate into bicarbonate plus of H plus ion. So that's what carbonic anhydrase is a very important role during this transport of carbon dioxide in the blood. So now the answer will be second option, carbonic anhydrase with zinc as a cofactor. Now move to question number 22. So what they gave in that 22nd question, the M phase means mitotic phase starts with the dash corresponding to the separation of daughter chromosomes, known as dash. and usually ends with a division of cytoplasm, which is known as dash. What is that? In mitotic phase, start with what? Nuclear division. Division of first nucleus takes place. Then corresponding to the separation of daughter chromosome takes place at the end of this karyokinesis. Karyokinesis is nothing but what? A division of nucleus only. And usually ends with the division of cytoplasm. What is the division of cytoplasm? Is called cytokinesis. Cytokinesis, karyokinesis and nuclear division. So second option is the correct answer for this question. So now move to question number 23rd. So what they give in that 23rd question? During G1, so G1 phase of cell division. So usually in cell division you will find two main important phases. So first one is called interphase, second one M phase or mitotic phase. In interphase you will find G1, S, and in G2. G1 phase, what happens? Starting of RNA and protein synthesis takes place. In S phase, a duplication of DNA. DNA will get duplicated, means what? So 2C will become 4C. Duplication of DNA, along with that chromosomes will also get duplicated in S phase. What about G2? So completion of, already they have started in G1 phase RNA and protein synthesis. Completion of RNA and protein takes place in at the end of G2 phase. So now the correct answer will be, what happens? RNA and proteins are synthesized or started the synthesis in G1 phase and completes in G2 phase. So this answer for this question will be option A or option number one, RNA and proteins are synthesized. Now question number 24. Listen carefully. This is very important question from the physiology point of view or cell cycle, cell division. You have to remember, choose the correct statement with respect to mitosis. Which is that correct statement? First statement, what they gave, chromosomes move to the spindle equator and get aligned along the equatorial plate in metaphase. This is correct, true statement only. Always spindle fibers will get completely lie on the equatorial plate along with chromatids and centromere. Then second option, chromatids separate but remain in the center of the cell in anaphase. No, so chromatids, when they will get separate, now they will move towards the opposite poles. How they will move? So like this and like this. So this is complete splitting. After splitting of centromere, they will go both moving towards the opposite pole. So now this will be the wrong statement. And third one, chromatids start moving towards opposite poles in telophase. Wrong one. So in which phase? Anaphase. Last one, Golgi complex endoplasmic reticulum are still visible at the end of late prophase. No, disintegration takes place. Disintegration means option first one is the correct answer for this question 24th. Then followed by question number 25. During cell division, the spindle fibers attaches to centromere. At which region? Direct answer will be kinetochore. You have to remember. Next, followed by 26th question. The DNA replication during S phase results in which of the following changes in content? S phase, I have already told you that duplication of DNA takes place. So what? Duplication of DNA. In NCERT also they have mentioned as 2C will become 4C. DNA content will get completely doubled. So this answer will be the amount of DNA per cell doubles, represented as 4C. First it will be 2C, when it enters S phase it will become 4C. Now the answer will be second option. Then move to question number 27. Which of the following is correctly matched? Prophase spindle fibers attaches to kinetochore of chromosome. Is this correct? So wrong one. So not in prophase, this is in metaphase. Instead of metaphase, they gave in prophase. This is wrong statement. Telophase, nucleolus, Golgi complex and endoplasmic reticulum reappears. Is it or not? This is exact. Telophase is the opposite of prophase. This is correct one. Anaphase, chromatids move to opposite poles. Correct only. Metaphase, centromere split and chromatids will get separate. Wrong one. Splitting will occur in anaphase. Which one are correctly matched? Both second and third. Means first option is correct. Next followed by question number 28. If 34 chromosomes are present in each daughter nucleus during telophase 2. This is end of the meiosis 2. How many chromosomes are found at each pole in meiosite at anaphase 1? Anaphase 1 is nothing but reductional division. Is it or not? Reductional division. For example, so 64 chromosomes are there means in anaphase 1. So what division takes place? Reduction takes place that reduces to 34. For example, 666 are there means, so, or 68 are there means they will become reducers to 34. At the end of telophase, they are asking, at the end of telophase, they have 34 means here, and of course, in anaphase, what will happen? Division takes place and 34. So, means in both anaphase 1 and telophase 2, both will have 34 chromosomes. So, 28 will be third option. Next, move to question number 29. Human physiology. So in breathing and exchange of gases, you've already studied this concept. Alveolar ducts form the termination of. So alveolar, how these will get formed? So first bronchi, then bronchioles, primary bronchial, secondary bronchial, tertiary bronchial, then respiratory bronchial, then followed by alveoli. So this chain you have to remember. So now the answer will be, of course, respiratory bronchioles are the termination into alveolar duct. Alveolar duct will get opens into alveoli. Bag-like structure that involved in exchange of gases. Next, move to question number 30. Trachea is lined by what type of epithelium? Of course, this correct answer is pseudo-stratified. They have to give actually columnar. Pseudo-stratified columnar ciliated epithelium. So, 30th answer will be second option. Next, move to 31st. What they gave in 31st? Volume of thoracic cavity in the vertical section. When thoracic cavity volume will get decreases during expiration process. What happens during expiration in all four options? Contraction of phrenic muscle. This is related to inspiration. Relaxation of internal intercostal muscles. This is not related with this. Relaxation of phrenic or diaphragm muscles relates to dome-shaped diaphragm. That is the correct answer. Contraction of external intercostal muscle. This is during inspiration. Now the correct answer will be relaxation of phrenic or diaphragm muscle that leads to decrease in the thoracic cavity and thoracic volume, thereby increasing the intrapulmonary pressure, thereby expelling out of the carbon dioxide takes place at the end of expiration process. So next followed by question number 32. Arrange the following in descending order. Descending means what? So from larger to smaller. So percentage of carbon dioxide transported. Transported how much percentage? 20 to 25%. Then percentage of oxygen transported through plasma, only 3%. Carbon dioxide transported in dissolved state will be 7 to 10%. Then percentage of oxygen transport through RBC maximum, 97%. In the form of bicarbonate, carbon dioxide in the form of bicarbonate, 70%. Now descending means from higher to lower. First D will come, the D percentage of oxygen. Next E. Lesser will be E. Lesser will be C. Lesser will be A. Lesser will be B. B will be least, 3%. Now you got this answer. Question number 32, option third will be the correct answer. Next, move to question number 33. So what is there in that? Study of the following statement carefully. Diaphragm is roughly flat in shape during inspiration. Correct only. It will become dome-shaped during expiration. Contraction of external intercostal muscles increases thoracic volume in dorsal ventral axis. This is correct only. Internal intercostal muscles contracted during forced inspiration. This is wrong one. During forced inspiration, This is wrong statement. So first and second are the correct answers for this. Next, move to 34. In which of the following in the following human lung studies identify the total lung capacity? So total lung capacity, in the sense, a direct answer you have to know C and D. C, what is that C? Vital capacity plus residual volume together called, it forms as total lung capacity, first option. Then 35th question, the difference in the partial pressure of oxygen of alveolar air. How much partial PO2, partial pressure of oxygen of alveolar air, is 104 mmHg. And pulmonary capillary, always in pulmonary capillary, deoxygenated blood. So deoxygenated blood, what is that partial pressure of oxygen? So 40 mmHg. So here 104 in alveolar air, 104 mmHg minus of 40. It means how much? 64 mmHg. Capillary will find 64 mmHg. Answer will be third option. Next, move to question number 36. Longest part of colon is, of course, transverse. So parts of colon are ascending, transverse, descending, and sigmoid. Last is called sigmoid. First is called ascending. Longest one is, longer one is transverse. Next, 37. By comparison between the milky teeth and the permanent teeth, how many them will grow only once? Monophodont means total 12. So 20 will get replaced. 20 will get replaced in their life. Question number 38. Lysosomes are secreted by dash or A and kill B. So lysosomes secreted specially in salivary juice also, along with that in small intestine also. By specialized cells you will find in small intestine are called Paneth cells. So Paneth cells will also secrete this lysosome, will also act as an antibacterial agent. What it kill? Bacteria. That's what it will act as an antibacterial agent. Paneth cell and bacteria. Another cell you will find in fourth option, Argentoffin cells. Argentoffin cells will specially will release a chemical substance called serotonin. So that serotonin will act as a vasoconstrictor. Vasoconstrictor in the sense what? It will involve in increasing BP by constriction of blood vessels. Thereby it increases BP. Option will be the third one. Next, move to question number 39. In which of the following location there is absence of sphincter? Between esophagus and stomach you will find cardiac sphincter or gastroesophageal sphincter. Between stomach and small intestine, pyloric sphincter will find. So between small intestine and large intestine, between ileum and cecum, ileo cecal sphincter. Last, colon and rectum you will not find. That answer will be the fourth option. Next, 40th question. The following is the secretory gland which are located at the crypts of the villi in small intestine. The name itself says crypts, related to glands of intestine, are also called crypts of Leberkuhn. That third option is the correct answer. Islets of Langerhans you will find in endocrine part of pancreas. It releases different endocrine hormones like insulin or glucagon. Lacteals are nothing but lymph vessels. Lymph vessel main function in the intestine, involved in absorption of fats. Absorption of fats. Now the answer will be the third option. Thank you.